हाय नैना, सो वी विल लर्न अबाउट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ मीजोमेरिक इफेक्ट। एक्चुअली व्हाट इज मीजोमेरिक इफेक्ट, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मीजोमेरिक इफेक्ट? इट इज नथिंग बट शिफ्टिंग ऑफ पाई इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम ए मल्टीपल बॉन्ड टू एन एटम। For example, let us take a, so here there is a double bond, multiple bond. Okay, shifting of these pi electrons, shifting of pi electrons. Okay, from a multiple bond to an atom or to a single bond. So this multiple bond is shifted to a single bond. Okay, so here multiple bond, there is a single bond. So this multiple bond, that means the pi bond from the multiple bond, it is shifted to a single bond. So that here only one bond is left over, and a single bond is converted into pi bond. Single bond is converted to multiple bond. Okay, or else shifting of multiple bond to an atom. So here what is happening, so multiple bond is there, that means double bond is there. One of the pi bond electrons, they will move to this oxygen atom. So pi bond, there was double bond, now the electrons of pi bond, it is shifted to oxygen atom. So now only single bond is left over. So like this, that means shifting of pi electrons from a multiple bond to a single bond, or else from a multiple bond to an atom, is called as mesomeric effect, or else it is also called as the resonance effect, or else we can simply say that transfer of unshared electron, or else a transfer of lone pair from an atom to adjacent single bond. For example, there is a structure like this. Okay, here, so there is a lone pair on this atom. So this lone pair, it is transferred to a single bond. And this multiple bond electrons are transferred to this atom. Got it? So as a result of this one, you will get a structure like this. Okay, you will get a structure like this. So what has happened here? So transfer of this lone pair, or else unshared pair of electrons from an atom to a single bond, okay, to a single adjacent single bond. So that the transfer is also called as mesomeric effect. Okay, the transfer of pi bond electrons to its adjacent atom, or else a transfer of lone pair of electrons to adjacent single bond, or else transfer of multiple bond, electrons from multiple bonds to its adjacent single bond. So all these are nothing but mesomeric effects. Okay, mesomeric effect can be simply defined like this: shifting of pi electrons from a multiple bond to an atom or to a single bond, or transfer of lone pair electrons from an atom to adjacent single bond. Okay, such effect is said to be mesomeric effect. See, it is a permanent effect. Permanent effect, it is not a temporary effect. It is operated in unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated compound means, so there should be multiple bonds. So in the compounds which contain multiple bonds, only in such compounds it is operated. I mean this mesomeric effect is found. Okay,
especially in conjugated compounds. Conjugated compounds means, so there should be alternate double bonds, or else double bond when alternated with a single bond and a lone pair of electrons. So like this, such a system is said to be conjugated system. Already we have seen different types of conjugated systems. Okay, see, in mesomeric effect, electrons are completely transferred. So here, these electrons are completely transferred here, and these electrons are completely transferred here. Whereas in inductive effect, there is only partial transfer of electrons. Already we have seen inductive effect also. In inductive effect, there is a partial transfer of electron. Whereas in mesomeric effect, electrons are completely transferred. Okay, next. At least two multiple bonds are in conjugation. So at least two multiple bonds are in conjugation, or a multiple bond in conjugation with a lone pair. So a multiple bond in conjugation with a lone pair, at least it should be like this. Okay, that means between a double bond and an atom containing a lone pair, there should be at least a single bond. Then only these two are said to be in conjugation. That means here one of the characteristics, important characteristics of mesomeric effect is, so there should be at least two multiple bonds at least. Okay, and these two are in conjugation. That means multiple bond, single bond, again multiple bond. So like this arrangement, or else multiple bond, single bond, and atom with a lone pair. Okay, such a, only under such certain condition, only under these conditions, the mesomeric effect takes place. Right? Here, only pi bond electrons or non-bonding electrons are involved. So here, this is non-bonding electrons, or else lone pair of electrons, they are involved, or else pi bond electrons are involved. That means delocalization. Delocalization means shifting, or else a movement of electrons. Which electrons will move? Either lone pair of electrons will move, or else multiple bond. Multiple bond means, so out of, suppose if there is a multiple bond, the sigma bond and pi bond, both the bonds together, okay, will form a multiple bond. The sigma bond electrons does not move. Only the pi bond electrons will move. Okay, that means here only pi bond electrons or non-bonding electrons, that means lone pair of electrons, are involved in a mesomeric effect. Whereas in inductive effect, sigma bond electrons are involved. So in inductive effect, but here in mesomeric effect, only pi bond electrons or else non-bonding electrons or lone pair electrons are involved. Right. Next, it is denoted by double headed arrow. Okay, so between two resonance structures. So this is one resonance structure, this is another resonance structure. So between two resonance structures, so here if you draw like, if you put a double headed arrow, then these two structures are said to be in mesomeric effect. Here also. Okay, that means if you draw a double headed arrow between two resonant structures, then it indicates that mesomeric effect is existing between those resonating structures, those structures. See, it is transmitted along a chain to any length with same effect. Okay, so to any length. So if electrons are shifted from one atom to some other atom which is placed at far away, even in that case also the same effect is felt. But whereas in inductive effect, as the distance increases, the effect, the inductive effect decreases. Whereas with increase in distance, the mesomeric effect does not change. This is most important point. So it is transmitted along a chain to any length, okay, with same effect. But one condition is necessary. What is that condition? If conjugation is available, okay. If conjugation is available, then the mesomeric effect, it is transferred to any length. For example, so here, so the electrons will move from here to here, from here to here, okay, from here to here. So that means delocalization of electrons is taking place. So here all these atoms are involved in conjugation. Okay, there is a conjugation. Conjugation is available. So that means what happens? The mesomeric effect. That means delocalization of electrons will take place to any length, to any distance, and the effect felt is same. So if it is here, or else on this carbon, or else on this carbon, or else on this carbon, the effect is same. Whereas in inductive effect, the effect it varies.
Okay, right. So these are the important characteristics of mesomeric effect. There are so many other characteristics also, but only important characteristics we will discuss. Okay, right. Next, mesomeric effect groups. There are two types of mesomeric effect groups. Okay, different types of groups which show mesomeric effect are classified into two types. What are they? We'll learn now. Mesomeric effect groups are classified into two types. Okay, what are they? One is plus mesomeric effect groups. Okay, these groups are also called as electron donating groups. Okay, these are also called as electron donating groups, minus ME groups. These are also called as electron withdrawing groups, electron donating groups and electron withdrawing groups. Okay, see here, these plus ME groups, this group in which, see this, actually what are plus ME groups? The group in which the directly attached atom is connected to more electronegative atom by a multiple bond. For example, if you take NO2 group, so if here, sorry, this is minus ME group, minus ME group and plus ME group. So here minus ME group means the group in which the directly attached atom is connected to more electronegative atom by a multiple bond. For example, if you take NO2 group, suppose if NO2 group is attached to a benzene ring or else any conjugated system like this, okay, see this NO2 group, so here this is an atom from this group, so it is directly attached to this group is attached to this molecule or is to the other part of the molecule through this atom, and this particular atom it is attached to more electronegative atom. Okay, the atom from the group which is directly attached to this other part of the molecule, it is directly attached to the more electronegative atom. So that is the condition. such a type of arrangement is present in minus Me groups. So minus Me groups, what does they do? They are electron. See, minus Me groups, they are called as electron withdrawing groups, and plus Me groups are called as electron donating groups. So what happens? So this group will take electrons. This group will take electrons from this molecule, other part of the molecule, because these electrons are shifted to this more electronegative atom. As a result of this one, what happens? So this pi bond will be in conjugation with this. Okay, now this pi bond electrons will move here. Okay, so as a result of this, what happens? So development of positive charge on this carbon, development of negative charge on this oxygen takes place. So like this, what happens? So here, delocalization of electrons is taking place through resonance or else through conjugation. Okay, so that means this particular group is attracting the electrons from the other part of the molecule. Such a group is said to be electron withdrawing group. Okay, then what are plus E group, plus Me groups? Plus Me groups, they will donate electrons. For example, let us take, so example NH2 group, amine group. So it is having a lone pair. So if amine group is attached to the conjugated system, here in this conjugated system, the lone pair on the atom from this plus Me group. So this is plus Me group. The lone pair which is present on the atom, and that atom is directly attached to the conjugated system. What happens? So here, this lone pair will enter into the system. So what happens? So here double bond is formed, and this electron, this pi bonded electrons, they will move. They will move here, and this pi bonded electrons will move here, and this pi bonded electrons will move here. So that means delocalization of pi bond electrons will take place. So here what happens? The lone pair and the pi bond, they are in conjugation. All these pi bonds are in conjugation with the lone pair. So what is happening as a result of this one? So this, from this group, the electrons are entering into the system, other part of the molecule. That hence this group is said to be electron donating group. Electron donating group. This group is donating electrons to the other part of the molecule, whereas this group is taking electrons from the other part of the molecule. Hence this particular group is said to be electron withdrawing group. Minus Me groups are called as electron withdrawing groups, and plus Me groups are called as electron donating groups. The group which directly attached to atom, if it possesses lone pair, the group which is directly attached to this molecule through an atom, and that atom, if the group in which directly attached atom possesses a lone pair of electrons, or sometimes this may possess negative charge also, lone pair of electrons or negative charge, then it is said to be plus Me group. Okay, so there are so many plus Me group except a phenyl group. So phenyl group, it is not a plus Me group. Okay, so like this we can discuss about groups, mesomeric effect groups. Okay, next, applications of mesomeric effect. So now we will learn about the applications of mesomeric effect. Okay, so mesomeric effect is used. It is it is most useful in many cases in order to explain the stability of allyl carbocation. In order to compare the stability of allyl carbocation with alkyl carbocation, and also in order to explain the stability of benzyl carbocation. Okay, in order to explain the stability of allyl and benzyl free radicals. In order to explain the acidity of aromatic carboxylic acids, in order to explain the acidity of phenols. Okay, so that means with the help of mesomeric effect, so we can explain the acidity of phenols, acidity of aromatic carboxylic acids, and also the basicity of aromatic amines, etc. So all these things will are said to be, there are so many other applications also. These are the most important applications where mesomeric effect will explain, it is used. So first of all, we'll learn all these things. So we'll go with the stability of allyl carbocation and benzyl carbocation. What is allyl carbocation? When the positive charge on carbon is shared by more atoms, the stability will increase more. For example, allyl carbocations, there are several types. So they are primary allyl carbocations, secondary allyl carbocation, and tertiary allyl carbocation. See, generally one thing we have to know. So whenever a charge on an atom, if it is shared by more than one atom, if the charge is shared by more than one atom, then stability of the molecule will increase. So this is the thing. If a charge is shared by more than one atom, then the stability will increase. So now you learn about allyl carbocations. So there are three types of allyl carbocations: primary allyl carbocation, secondary allyl carbocation, and tertiary allyl carbocation. So what is primary allyl carbocation? So here a double bond, when it is adjacent to when it is in conjugation with a positive charge, okay, positive charged carbon. So now it is said to be allyl carbocation. So this is allyl group, and this is called as allyl carbocation. So what happens in this allyl carbocation? See, if you see this allyl carbocation, so this pi bond electrons will shift here. As a result of this one, what happened? So between these two carbon atoms, electron density increases. Okay. Now, as a result of this one, what happens? So electron density, that means this single bond will become multiple bond. Okay. Here the positive charge, it will be shifted to this carbon. That means this positive charge is shared by both this carbon and even this carbon. So whenever a charge on an atom, if it is shared by more than one atom, then stability increases. So in this way, this molecule will become stable molecule by sharing its positive charge to other atom through resonance. So this is happening through conjugation. That means delocalization of electrons.
Okay, so this is primary carbo primary allyl carbocation. So in primary allyl carbocation, what happens? Positive charge is shared by two atoms. Positive charge is shared. It is shared by two atoms. Then what is secondary allyl carbocation? Secondary allyl carbocation. Secondary allyl carbocation. So in secondary allyl carbocation, okay. So it is like this. CH2 double bond CH. Okay. Again this structure, again it is repeated on the other side. So this is called a secondary allyl carbocation. So here what happens? If these electrons move here, delocalization here, then what happens? We will get a structure like this. CH2 plus charge, single bond, double bond, CH. Okay, so now C double bond CH2. Suppose if this double bond moves here, then we will get a structure like this. CH2 double bond C, CH double bond C, CH2. Then in this case, so if these pi electrons moves here, what happens? So here this carbon will get positive charge. So that means there is a chance of shifting of this pi bond here, or else this pi bond here. So that what happens? Thus that a positive charge, it is shared by this carbon or else this carbon. So that means there are chances of in secondary allyl carbocation. So here three carbon atoms will share the positive charge. So here positive charge is shared by three carbon atoms. So if number of carbon atoms are increased, or else here suppose if here how many resonating structures are there? In primary allyl carbocations only there are two resonating structures, but for secondary allyl carbocation there are three resonating structures. So as the number of resonating structures increases, the stability will increase. Why? Because as number of resonating structures are increasing, what happens? The positive charge is shared by the sharing of positive charge will increase by more number of atoms. That means more number of atoms will participate in sharing the charge. Okay, so that means when compared to primary allyl carbocation, the secondary allyl carbocation is more stable, because here there are three resonating structures, but here only two resonating structures. Now if you see tertiary allyl carbocation, so once again I am drawing secondary allyl carbocation. So this is one structure. So these three resonating structures are there for secondary allyl carbocation. If you see about the tertiary allyl carbocation, in tertiary allyl carbocation, so here it will be like this: CH2 double bond C, CH, C double bond CH2.
So there is a positive charge on this. Again C double bond CH2. So this is called as a tertiary allyl carbocation. In tertiary allyl carbocation, so this double bond may shift here, or else this double bond may shift here, or else this double bond may shift here. So as a result of this, what happens? Suppose if this double bond shift here, so here the positive charge will come here onto this carbon. Single bond, double bond C, C double bond CH2, C double bond CH2, CH here. Okay. So it will be like this. Here also CH, 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 CH. Okay. So here, this positive charge may shift to this carbon, or else to this carbon. Or else it may shift it to this carbon also. So this is positive charge. This is positive charge on this carbon. So here, this positive charge is shared by 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms. So here there are 4 resonating structures. As the number of atoms sharing that positive charge is increased in tertiary allyl carbocation, so this tertiary allyl carbocation is more stable than the secondary allyl carbocation, and secondary allyl carbocation is more stable than primary allyl carbocation. Whenever the number of resonating structures increases, okay, then that molecule is more stable. So we can write the order of stability of allyl carbocations like this. So tertiary is more stable than secondary, and secondary is more stable than primary. So stability order of allyl carbocations, so can be written like this. Stability order of allyl carbocation, if you write like this, so tertiary allyl carbocation is more stable than secondary allyl carbocation, and secondary allyl carbocation is more stable than primary allyl carbocation, because the number of resonating structures are increased, and the positive charge is shared by more number of atoms as we move from primary allyl carbocation to secondary allyl carbocation, and from secondary allyl carbocation to tertiary allyl carbocation. So the atoms sharing the positive charge, it is increasing. So like this, we can discuss about the stability of allyl carbocation. We can compare the allyl carbocations with alkyl carbocation. Allyl carbocation can be compared with alkyl carbocation. Suppose if you take only primary allyl carbocation and compare with tertiary alkyl carbocation, generally if you see alkyl carbocation, alkyl carbocations, again these are also three types: primary alkyl carbocation, secondary alkyl carbocation, and tertiary alkyl carbocation. So out of these three, so tertiary alkyl carbocation is more stable than secondary alkyl carbocation, and secondary alkyl carbocation is more stable than primary alkyl carbocation. So here allyl carbocation and here alkyl carbocation. Okay, see, in alkyl carbocations, they are stabilized by what? they are stabilized by inductive effect. Whereas allyl carbocations, they are stabilized by mesomeric effect. Okay, that means out of three alkyl carbocations, tertiary alkyl carbocation is more stable. Now, out of three allyl carbocations, tertiary alkyl carbocation is more stable. Now, if you compare these two, so this primary allyl carbocation is more stable than tertiary alkyl carbocation. So, primary allyl carbocation is more stable than tertiary alkyl carbocation. Because here the stability is due to mesomeric effect, but here the stability is due to inductive effect. If you draw the structures of these two and compare, so primary allyl carbocation, if it is like this, and tertiary alkyl carbocation, will be like this. So here, what happens? So here the positive charge, it is partially stabilized, but here the positive charge is completely stabilized. So here what happens? Electrons, delocalization or shifting of electrons takes place, only partial shifting. Whereas in this case, mesomeric effect, complete transfer of electron takes place. Here it is inductive effect. In inductive effect, only partial transfer of electrons takes place. So here actually, this positive charge is shared by only two compounds. Positive charge is shared by only two compounds. But in this case, the positive charge is shared by four atoms. The positive charge is shared by four atoms. But still this is less stable than this. Why? Because here the shifting of electrons is partial shifting, whereas here in this case the shifting of electron is complete shifting, complete transfer of charge takes place. But here what happens? So here from here to here, the positive charge decreases. From here to here, the positive charge decreases. From here to here, positive charge decreases. Here to here, positive charge decreases. Okay, but here from in this case, so here positive charge is completely transferred here. So complete transfer of charge takes place. Whenever complete transfer of charge takes place, then that will be more stable when compared to the transfer of charge by partial transfer of charge. Okay, here as that. As the transfer of charge is partial, hence this is less stable. Okay, so like this we can compare the allyl carbocations with alkyl carbocations. Out of several alkyl carbocations, tertiary alkyl carbocation is more stable, and its stability is less than the primary allyl carbocation. Okay, so like this we can discuss about or else we can compare the stability of allyl carbocations with the alkyl carbocations, okay, with the help of mesomeric effect. Next, we'll discuss about benzyl carbocation. What is benzyl carbocation? When the carbocation is adjacent to benzene ring, when the carbocation is adjacent to benzene ring, then it is said to be benzyl. It is said to be benzyl carbocation. For example, so this is benzene ring. If it is adjacent to if the carbocation is adjacent to benzene ring, then it is said to be what? Benzyl carbocation. Okay. So what happens? So actually, the carbocations, even benzyl carbocations are also three types: primary benzocarbyl cation, secondary benzocarbyl carbocation, and tertiary benzyl carbocation. So this is primary benzyl carbocation. Okay, secondary benzyl carbocation will be like this. That means this carbocation is attached to this carbocation. It is attached to two benzene rings. This carbocation is attached to two benzene rings. Here, the carbocation, it is attached to only one benzene ring. In tertiary allyl tertiary benzyl carbocation, so the carbon cation, it is attached to three benzene rings. It is attached to three benzene rings. So like this. So like this. This is tertiary benzyl. Tertiary benzyl carbocation. Okay, see, if you observe the primary benzyl carbocation, so how the delocalization takes place, how the positive charge is shared by more than one atom. Okay, see, look here, this pi bond will shift here. As a result of this, this positive charge will shift here. Okay, so I'll draw the structure. So this structure will result, and again this pi bond will shift here. Okay, so now next resonance structure will be, here and the positive charge will shift here, and next this pi bond will shift here. What happens? Next resonating structure will be like this, and positive charge, this positive charge will shift here. So that means this particular positive charge, it is shared by 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms. While moving throughout the, here, what is happening? So pi bonds are shifting. They are shifting their position. So here pi bond is there. So, but this pi bond is moved here. And this pi bond is moved here. So like this. Okay. So this is the way how mesomeric effect takes place in primary benzyl carbocation. As a result of this one, 1, 2, 3, 4 are sharing that positive charge. Okay. Now if you come to secondary benzyl carbocation, with this ring, the four structures will occur. And even with this ring also, the four structures will occur. So that means, so here four and there four. So here four and there extra three. So seven carbons are sharing the positive charge here. Here, four carbons are sharing the positive charge. Even this ring also will show the same effect. How this ring is showing? even the other ring also will show the same effect. Hence, the number of resonating structures will increase. Here only, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4 resonating structures. But here, so some number of resonating structures will increase because even this ring also will participate in the resonance in the same fashion. In tertiary benzyl carbocation, there are 3 rings will which participate in resonance, and every ring will show such type of delocalization. Hence, in this case, the number of resonating structure will further increase. That is why, as the number of resonating structures are further increased, so the number of atoms sharing this positive charge will be more in tertiary benzyl carbocation, and it is somewhat less in secondary benzyl carbocation, and still less in primary benzyl carbocation. Hence, the tertiary benzyl carbocation is more stable than secondary benzyl carbocation, and secondary benzyl carbocation is more stable than primary benzyl carbocation. So like this, the stability of benzyl carbocations can be explained. Okay, as number of resonating structures increases, stability increases. So like this, we can discuss. So this is the first application of mesomeric effect. Okay, now we will learn the other applications. We learn the other applications in the next video.